Well, let me turn on the prosthetic, and I will tell you a little bit about everything. When I was younger, I used to get bullied at school because I was a different guy. I was born with a genetic disease called Poland syndrome, which is basically this. I'm missing my right forearm. And then I played a lot with Lego bricks. That was my main escape route, and I decided to keep using those as innovation tools. So I built, when I was 9, my first Lego prosthetic to show the others that even with one arm I can be equal to them. And for me it was very super important accomplishment because I realized that with normal bricks I could do prosthetics. So I needed to try the newer and more sophisticated technic bricks that appear in my newer prosthetics. So I decided to go ahead, and when I was 17 I designed my first Lego technic prosthetic. And after upgrading, this one is fully automated because I just need to push one button, which is located right here. It's this black and white button. And with this little pusher or slider, I can just put the prosthetic, it doesn't fall off because of friction. And if I can click halfway in, I can go up by just clicking a little bit. And I can go down just by clicking fully. It wasn't because I wanted to use both hands, because I adapted completely to my physical condition. And prosthetics are just a tool to show that even with a little bit of confidence in yourself, you can do crazy stuff, even with one arm. When I was 17, I created the Han Solo logo. The name comes from a friend that told me you should use Han Solo because you have one arm, you know, you just have one hand. I was like, okay, that's super funny. And that's a way to make fun of myself. And that's something that I really enjoy. When I finished building the first prosthetic, my father knew this was going to explode in a way or another. So he bought the rights of the name. And we were doing the documentary with producer in Andorra. After, we decided to keep up the story with a book. So my father started the book and we finished it together. And we recently got an email saying that there was an interest from Hollywood to get the rights of the book and maybe do a movie in Hollywood, in the big screen. So I would love to see what actor they take as Han Solo. Maybe, I don't know, I would love to see Tom Holland with just one arm, you know, and to wear my cool prosthetics. That would be incredibly awesome. This is another way that intellectual property is supporting my passion. My project right now is to try and make prosthetics more affordable and fun for children. Maybe with a Lego 3D printed prosthetic, they can just have fun building their own hand. A lot of people around the world need someone as an example. And there's a lot of families that have the same experience as my parents when I was born. It's just a not very pleasant surprise to have a child with a physical condition like mine. But in the end, there's nothing to be sad about, because the people that are born like me, they end up accomplishing every single one of their dreams. You know, so the only thing that they need is just love.